Hello everybody, in this video I will use NodeJS to get data from TTN aka the Things Network via MQTT protocol. And sorry if you can't listen what I'm talking because I speak English not well, but don't worry about that, I will try to add subtitle in this video. Okay, let's start. First, we have to set up some things like git bash to use Linux environment on Windows, or you can use CMD on Windows, or you can use a Linux OS such as Ubuntu. Okay. Second, you have to download and install Node.js in your Windows, because I don't guide you how to do that in this video. And the last one, if we use the Node.js, we need to set up some NPM libraries such as spread, MQTT, socket, base64, MySQL, etc. But just Google how to download them if you didn't install them before. But in this video, if we lack some library, we will install them directly because it's recommended on the Node.js terminal. Don't worry about that. Okay, next. Okay, here's some notice about this. In this video, I will create a basic Node.js project. You can create it by yourself or use the old one if you had already know Node.js before. The reason I want to create a basic Node.js is I want to show for newbies who don't know about how to do that. Okay, and the second notice is this video, I mean this video and the previous one, which is set up gateway with hat Lora, are not relevant to each other because the previous video is from my friends, and in this video I just set up an application to get data, and this video is independent. It's not relevant to the previous one because I don't have the hardware here, so I cannot show you how project work. Just show you how to get data by simulation from TTN website. Yeah, sorry about that. Okay, there are two ways to do that. The first one is use the Things Network Node.js application SDK, that's a TTN NPM libraries. And the second one is I will show you how to create your own server with Node.js. Okay. Now I will create an application and a device. About the TTN cloud, you can use AU1 or EU1 based on your area. Okay. AU1 is Australia. Yeah. Okay. Just go to application and add application here. I will create a application in YouTube demo ID and copy here YouTube demo name. Okay, demo YouTube, create application, and here you have to go to add devices and add a device right here, because I don't have any hardware, so I don't care about it brand. So if you have your node, you have to set up as in this list. Okay, I will go to manually because I don't care about the Lora device. I just leave it Mac here, just give it random because I live in Asia, so I will select Asia. Just generate. Okay, generate, and this is my end device ID, so remember this ID. Okay, register end device. Okay, already done to how to create a device and application. Okay, move to the next line. Okay, now I will show you how to set up Node.js project and use TTN shortcode. Okay, I have a folder here. If you had already set up git bash, just right click into the folder and select git bash here. Please type npm init. And I have a name TTN YouTube demo. Just leave here default by enter, and my name is Anquan. Okay. Already done. Next important library, that's the npm install express. Okay, done. Now I will go to this website. Oh no, this packet has been deprecated, but don't worry about that. Okay, please don't use this command because it will download the latest version. But I will show you how to do with the older version. It's better. Okay, and it's easier than the latest one. Okay, here I will open the terminal and paste the command here. Just enter. Okay, already done. Now, watch to the slide. I will go to this folder. Node modules, TTN, dist, and here there are three files to help you create a host to get data. I will use Node example to host a server which listen uplink data. Okay, example here. Okay, there's a lot of default code, and if we go to the index.js, nothing here, and client.js. Okay, in this file, you have to edit this line to shape, and next, you have to add a case here, a case with your NDFI ID. Your NDFI ID is this, copy and then paste it here with a string, paste. Oops. Okay, then copy the code here, copy all of this, copy and then paste it here. But worry about that, you don't need a metadata. Don't need bar, don't need counter, don't need field, don't need anything. Just have a field payload. Then get the payload. Okay. Save it. Okay. But here, oh sorry, here you have a new topic uplink YouTube. That's just a sample. Okay, that's it all for client.js. You have to go to example and copy this code, then paste and uplink YouTube topic. Okay, that's already done. And here you have to input your app UI and access key. Okay, go back to CloudSync network and select integrations and MQTT. Yeah, this is the application ID. Copy and paste it into FEUI here. Oops. Okay. And then a set key, you have to generate new API. And then copy this. Okay. Just paste it here. Save it. And next you have to edit this, go back here, copy this, oops, just copy the from AU1 to network, copy and paste it here. Okay, I think everything is done, just save it. And now go to this and right click git bash here, just leave a node example.js. Okay, here if you see a terminal display debug connected, it mean you cannot connect to the TTN network. Now I will go back to TTN and go to devices, live data, messaging to send something from the TTN network to our host. Okay, I will send 0.8. Okay, there are nothing here, but when I simulate uplink, yeah, they show success uplink sent, and you can see your data here. Everything is here. Yeah, it seems we don't have any color. It's hard to see, so I will move back to example.js. No need to parse it to JSON stringify. Just bring it. Okay. Now I will terminate and rerun again. Oops, JS. Okay, connected. Now I will simulate another 0F, simulate uplink. Okay, here you can see. It's easy to see, right? Because your data from TTN is a JSON object, so you have to point to the field which is hold your data, that is frame payload. Okay, now I have to point to this field by point to payload and point to uplink message, and then point to frame payload. Okay, let's start again. Okay, you can see you can get the data here, but this data is encoded in Base64, so you have to decode to know what is this. So I have a library to do that. That is Node.js Base64. You have to use this command to install into the project. Okay, copy and then just download it. Okay. This is a sample. I have to include this. Include it here, then use this to decode. Okay, here after I print, I have a variable to keep that data var raw data bank messenger.payload.uplink.message.frame.payload. Then I will paste the decoded basically for decode and pass this raw data into the parameter. Then I will bring it to the terminal decoded. You can put it here var, it's okay. Okay, now let's try node.example.js, send the other data. Oops. Because this is based on the char actor, so you cannot see the char actor here. I think that is a special char actor. So I will try to put the number is 01, simulate uplink, and you can see this is the char actor, so I think you have to change it to the integer or hex. Convert character to integer Node.js here. Okay, I think this is the best solution. Copy and dot here Okay, let's see what happened. Okay, you got the number one. I'm trying to put the the hex. Yeah, it is 10, because 10 in decimal is the A in hexa. Okay, yeah. Okay, and this is the first way to get the data from TTN. So I have a tips here. You can bring files above. That means you can bring the three of these files into your workplace if you want to integrate this TTN shortcode into your project to get the data. Yeah.